no, no, that is room would see no more quedrima. A bassa up modin pain for the duanua, ya woman win me, woman penny papa. A book creates make us woman him. Ah, no, no, ya na, and said that ain't call you papa. Na no, and no swap for shell zongo punsio as so I won it Musa for her meat. Or not so akasa dear chap modin pain for him send it dear mother. And cram of four manner who see a seam, a channel for now who see a seam, a suffer than a senti, and you can see a taste one more bra or ye juma.
Every day, I get complaints from nurses in various government health facilities complaining that their supervisors and senior nursing officers ask them to remove the hijab. Otherwise, they should go home. They cannot work as nurses. Now, I want to look straight into the cameras and say something. It is very, very important. And I want nursing officers, midwives, supervisors of hospitals across the country to listen to me and listen good. That we are all subject to the Fourth Republican Constitution. And Article 21, Clause 1C, states that every citizen of Ghana shall have the right to profess the religion of his or her choice. End quote. And the operative word, and to manifest it. And I want to emphasize the word manifest. Now, I want these nursing supervisors and so on to tell me how else you can identify a Muslim woman. How else a Muslim woman can manifest her, for want of a better term, her Islamness, if there's anything like that. How do we identify a soldier who is not in uniform? We call somebody an immigration officer simply because he's in uniform. It's as simple as that. We call somebody a policeman because he's in uniform. Once he throws the uniform away, you are unable to tell who he is. So, whilst it is not a symbol of piety, it is a symbol of identity. And identity is manifestation. And the Constitution says they have the right to manifest. I got another complaint from a lady who works with the psychiatric hospital, Accra Psychiatric Hospital. It's here. They wrote this to her. Accra Psychiatric Hospital. Memo. Nursing Administration to Adiza to Ibrahim. And now listen. They tell her, on the said date, you were in a hijab, and the deputy director of nursing services wanted to be sure you were aware of the consequences of wearing a hijab. Wow. Are there consequences in our country for wearing a hijab? And then he goes out to say that it is because they are working in a mental health facility and people who are mentally unstable will pull the hijab. She says, at a psychiatric hospital, a number of female staff had been injured by patients who were able to get hold of either, and now she doesn't list hijab, she says to get hold of either the hair or the clothing. So then all mental health facility working women should shave.
Wabra so off winning central for CIA and now this has me too.